My dear student friends, in today's lecture, let us study the viral diseases of silkworms. The silkworm Bombyx mori, an economical important insect, is affected by several diseases: grassery, densonucleosis, infectious flatulency, pebrine, muscardon, aspergillosis, and bacterial flatulency are commonly prevalent diseases. These are caused by different pathogens: nuclear polyhedrosis virus, densonucleosis virus, infectious flatulency virus, Nasima bombicis, Bivaria bassiana, and aspergillosis species. About 30 to 40% of the total crop in a year was lost due to diseases in India during 1960s. But later, with the advent of improved silkworm rearing technology, the crop loss has come down to around 15 to 20% in the 1980s. Recently, the crop loss due to diseases is around 10% owing to improved silkworm disease management technologies. For better appreciation, the topic is being explained into different subheadings, and they are: number 1, nuclear polyhedrosis; number 2, cytoplasmic polyhedrosis; number 3, infectious flatulency; number 4, densonucleosis. Let us see the first aspect of our study, the nuclear polyhedrosis. Among the viral diseases, the nuclear polyhedrosis or grassery is most common and severe than other viral diseases in all sericultural countries. The diseases is also known as milky diseases, jaundice, hanging diseases, and fat degeneration diseases. Nuclear polyhedrosis prevails to an extent of 33 to 55%. The diseases was recorded as early as in 18th century. Pilot named the virus as Borrelia bombicis. The virus was first to be detected in insects belonging to Bacilloviridae, the infection of which was called nuclear polyhedrosis. These viruses are easily recognizable from other viruses because of the presence of unique bodies. The polyhedra in 1856, the Nastri and Corellia observed these bodies in diseased silkworm larvae and named them as polyhedral granules, and the disease polyhedral disease or polyhedrosis. Bergold identified the rod shaped viral particles from the polyhedral bodies of diseased silkworms in 1947. The nuclear polyhedrosis in silkworms is classified as Bombyx mori nuclear polyhedrosis virus, a Bacillovirus of the family Bacilloviridae, subfamily E. Bacilloviridae. The nucleocapsid, which represent the virus, is found occluded in a crystalline protein polyhedrin, and the structure is known as polyhedra. The polyhedra vary in size from 0.5 to 15 um in diameter. The polyhedra are hexagonal, pentagonal, or tetragonal, clear, transparent, and light up very strongly in the dark field microscope. The polyhedra are heavier than water and settle to the bottom in the aqueous solution. Next, symptoms. The silkworms appear normal and show no symptoms or change in appetite during first 2 to 3 days of infection. The symptoms due to the BMNPV infection, that is nuclear polyhedrosis virus, are not apparent for several days. Usually, the first symptoms appear 5 to 7 days post infection. The integument develops shining, and the intersegmental region becomes swollen and fragile. There may be a overlapping of intersegmental membrane. The hemolymph became turbid, milky, white, and the fragile skin ruptures and the milky hemolymph oozes out. At the time of death, most of the organs are observed to have degenerated, liquefied, and the larva appear to be a bag of polyhedral bodies. The polyhedra, the diseased larvae, sometimes are seen hanging head down. Silkworm pupae and moths develop no specific morphological changes during the greater part of the incubation period. But by the end of the disease cycle, the integument became fragile and easily ruptures, releasing the liquefied pupal tissues. Some black markings are observed on the body surface of the pupae at the time of death. Next, infection. The most common route of infection by BMNPV in silkworm is perhaps. Silkworms get infected when they feed on mulberry leaves contaminated with BMNPV polyhedra. Polyhedral derived virons causes the secondary infection. The diseased larvae ooze large number of infectious polyhedra along with hemolymph on injury or rupture of integument. Next, progressive infection. The polyhedra on ingestion began to dissolve within 0.5 minutes and are dissolved completely within 3 minutes, liberating the virons. The dissolution is assisted by the alkalinity in the gut. These virons pass through the peritropic membrane and invade midgut columnar epithelial cells. Attachment, fusion, and viral entry occur rapidly within 25 minutes to 4 hours. From peroral infection and the nucleocapsids moves to nucleus. Next, susceptibility. In silkworms, a large differences exist among various strains in the susceptibility to BMNPV infection. Silkworms gain tolerance with age. Silkworms feed on mulberry with low protein, sucrose, or high cellulose, develops increased susceptibility to BMNPV infection. Humidity in association with high temperature enhance development of nuclear polyhedrosis. Any temperature higher or lower to 25 degrees Celsius tend to act as a stressor and increases the larval susceptibility to viral infections. Next, alternate host. The BMNPV infects several insects such as Philosomia cynthia perhari, Limentera disper japonica, and Dentorolimus spectobilis. The NPV of Somia resina also infects silkworm Bombyx mori. Next, management of nuclear polyhedrosis. The nuclear polyhedrosis in silkworm could be managed by practicing preventive measures. All silkworm breeds are susceptible to grassery, the adverse environmental factors such as high as well as low temperature and poor nutrition enhance the silkworm susceptibility as well as the rate of disease development. As such, it is essential to rear silkworms under congenial conditions of environment and nutrition. Now, let us see the second aspect of our study, cytoplasmic polyhedrosis. Cytoplasmic polyhedrosis is diseases caused by a reovirus. In silkworms, the cytoplasmic polyhedrosis was first reported by Ishimori in 1934. Ishimori observed a kind of polyhedrosis which was different from nuclear polyhedrosis. The CPV as double-stranded RNA and the Bombyx mori cytoplasmic polyhedrosis virus belongs to the genus Kypovirus. symptoms. The diseased silkworm develops atypical features of general flatulency. The larvae develop the signs and nutritional deep root or starved conditions. The larvae became sluggish, lost appetite, cease feeding and sometimes develop diarrhea and vomit gut juice. The cephalothoracic region appears transluent and body became shrunken. Sometimes the rectum portion of elementary canal protrudes. At the terminal stage of disease development, the larval body color changes, especially in the central region of the body. In this region, the midgut color and appearance changes from transluence due to clear midgut to opaque yellow and white color. The whitish midgut becomes clearly visible through larval integuments. The infected midgut is fragile and exudes whitish fluid when broken into the gut lumen containing large number of polyhedra. The infected larvae die in 10 to 15 days. Infected pupae are generally smaller than the normal and the infected moth lay fewer eggs and are short-lived. Next, infection. The primary route of entry of pathogen is perhaps the silkworm gets infected on consumption of mulberry contaminated with polyhedra. The secondary source of infection is polyhedra from fecus of the diseased silkworms. The diseased larvae may also release the infectious unit into the environment through the vomiting of gut juice and on death due to putrefaction. Next, progressive infection. The process of infection by Bombyx mori cytoplasmic polyhedrosis virus in silkworms begins with ingestion of polyhedra. The polyhedra are dissolved in the midgut and the virons are released. The liberated virons attach to the midgut columnar epithelial cells by the spikes present in the viral surface. The viral RNA is released through the spike as a filament into the cell cytoplasm, leaving the empty viral shell on the cell surface. The inoculative force appears to result from the contraction of elastic inner shell or membrane. The BMCPV penetrate into the midgut cell in the region posterior to 7th abdominal segment and then infection spreads towards the cephalic region of the midgut. Although the midgut is the site of infection and multiplication of the pathogen, it distributes the function of the midgut, leading to nutritional deficiency and flaccid condition in the larvae. The virogenic stroma is formed in the cytoplasm of infected cells. As the infection progresses, several virogenic stroma grow out towards the cell base and fuse to form a large matrices, where numerous free viral particles and small polyhedra are distributed irregularly over the surface of virogenic stroma. Although the polyhedron protein synthesized may be detected by 9 hours after inoculation at the sites near the border of midgut cells, the first polyhedron appears at about 15 hours of post-inoculation. Next, susceptibility. In silkworms, a large differences exist among various strains in their susceptibility to infectious by Bombyx mori cytoplasmic polyhedrosis virus. The resistance to BMCPV increases with age. early instars are comparatively more susceptible than later instars. Silkworms feed on mulberry grown in shade, tender, yellowish and long stored leaves aid in the high incidence of cytoplasmic polyhidrosis. The inadequate nutritional level in the leaves make the larvae susceptible to the pathogen. It was also observed that low temperature induces the diseases in silkworms. Next, alternate host. BMCPV cause low level of infection in the fall webworm. Ipanteria cunea, the BMCPV also infects Melacosoma isturata, Colis urthima and Theophilia mandarena, the CPV from Ipanteria cunea, Spodoptera litra, Lementria spectobilis and Theophilia mandarena cross infects Silkworm bombyx mori. Next, management of cytoplasmic polyhidrosis. Prevention of the diseases is the best approach as a curative measure or meet with limited success. Rearing of silkworms in pathogen-free environment ensures successful crop. Various chemicals have been recommended as general disinfectants. Judicious use of these disinfectants before start of rearing and making the rearing environment free from pathogens, and use of recommended bed disinfectants as per schedule saves the crops from diseases incidents. Apart from this, maintenance of personal and rearing hygiene is essential in making the crops successful. The third aspect of our study is infectious flatulence. Infectious flatulence is a highly contagious disease in silkworms and is caused by Picornia virus of family Picorniaviridae. These are among the smallest viruses in the animal kingdom. The virons are spherical particles of 26 to 37 nanometer in diameter with no projections. The virus nucleic acid is single-stranded RNA and is non-enveloped with a molecular weight of 2.4 into 10 to the power of 6 deltons. Four major structural proteins, VP1, VP2, VP3 and VP4, having molecular weight of 35,200, 33,000, 32,200 and 11,600 deltons respectively. Next, symptoms. Diseased silkworms develop a typical symptoms as the early stage of infection and the larvae appear lethargic and lose appetite. During the course of the diseases, the larvae became soft, flaccid and develop dysentric condition. They retard in growth, became dull, vomit gut juice and the fecus soft with high moisture content. Next, infection. The infection of silkworm is perhaps through contaminated mulberry leaf or through injured integument. The source of infection are fecus and gut juice of diseased larvae, contaminated egg surface and alternate hosts. Progressive infection. The midgut is the site of infection and multiplication. The virus infects primarily the globular cells. The columnar cells may also get infected. The infection initiates from anterior end, proceeds to posterior end and remains restricted to the midgut cell cytoplasm. The globular cells shrink in size, degenerate and are discharged into the lumen. The newly hatched and infected larvae die in 6 days, while the later instar larvae die in 12 to 13 days. Next, susceptibility. Susceptibility of different silkworm breeds to Bombyx mori infectious flatulency virus differs. In susceptible breeds, the number of infected globular cells increases continuously, while in resistant breeds, the infected globular cells decreases in number at every molt. Next, alternate host. Infectious flatulency virus has been observed to infect Bombyx mandarina and Gliopodus phalloides, a common pest of mulberry. These insects act as reservoir of pathogens, which in turn contaminates the mulberry, causing epizooties in silkworm colonies. Next, management of infectious flatulency diseases in silkworm rearing. The adverse environmental factors such as high as well as low temperature and poor nutrition enhance the silkworm susceptibility as well as the rate of disease development. Rearing silkworms in clean environment with congenial conditions and feeding with nutritious mulberry leaf are required for successful silkworm crops. The fourth aspect of our study is densonucleosis. Densonucleosis is a non-occluded viral disease in insects. The causative virus in silkworms belongs to the family Paroviridae, genera Densovirus. The infection causes hypertrophied nucleus containing dense voluminous fulgent positive masses of virons in the infected cells. The densonucleosis viral particles are non-enveloped isometric with a diameter of 19 to 24 nanometer. They contain small linear single-stranded DNA of molecular weight ranging from 0.5 to 2.2 × 10⁶ deltons and 4 to 6 structural polypeptides. Densonucleosis in silkworms prevail all through the year in all sericultural countries. The disease was first reported in 1968 in Nagano Prefecture in Japan. In a strain of Japan has been designated as densonucleus virus type 1, which was isolated from Ina city of Japan. Saku and Emanshi strain from Japan are designated as DNV type 2. Yet another strain isolated from Qingkong city of China is designated as DNV type 3. The Kenchu virus reported from India is considered as DNV type 2. These strains have different host range, pathogenicity and serological affinity. Next, symptoms. The BMDNV1 and BMDNV2 infection in silkworm results in development of disease with atypical symptoms. The major sign of diseases is flaccidity of the body. The cephalothoracic region will be translucent. The flaccidity and pale yellow color of the elementary tract without most of its content are similar to those caused by the infectious flachery virus in silkworms. The diseased larvae appear lethargic and lose appetite. At the later stage of infection, the larvae became soft, flaccid. The infection is acute and the larvae die in about 7 days, while in case of DNV 2. The disease is chronic and larvae die in 10 to 20 days after infection. Next, infection. The route of entry of pathogen is perhaps. The source of pathogen could be silkworm, fecus, rearing environment and alternate hosts. Diseased silkworms exclude the pathogen along with gut juice and fecus throughout the incubation period. The disintegrating diseased dead larvae also release the pathogen in the rearing environment. They contaminate the rearing house, appliances and rearing environment. Progressive infection. The virus on entry into the gut along with the feed infect the nuclei of the midgut columnar epithelial cells and the other tissues remain uninfected. Virus initiates the multiplication in the columnar epithelial cell nuclei and histopathological changes are manifested. In case of DNV infection, the infected cell nuclei became hypertrophied. Next, susceptibility. Several silkworm strains are genetically resistant to BMDNV1 or BMDNV2. The non-susceptibility of BMDNV1 infection is controlled by a single recessive gene, NSD1, or a dominant gene, NID1. The non-susceptibility of silkworms to BMDNV2 is also controlled by recessive gene NSD2. Environmental factors such as temperature could alter the rate of development of densonucleosis in silkworm. Alternate host. The densonucleosis epizootics in Japan have been attributed to the alternate host mulberry pyrolid gliopodus pylolis could be an alternate source for the pathogen. Management of densonucleosis in silkworm rearing. Rearing of silkworm breeds resistant to the disease is a way of managing these diseases. Rearing of silkworm in a clean and congenial environmental conditions with nutritious mulberry leaf helps in healthy growth of silkworm larvae. Rearing and personal hygiene are essential for disease-free and healthy growth of silkworms to produce quality cocoons. Thus, the topic can be summarized that there are 4 major types of viral diseases, namely nuclear polyhidrosis, cytoplasmic polyhidrosis, infectious flachery and densonucleosis in silkworms. These are caused by different types of viral pathogens. These diseases are distinctive in pathogen manifestation and symptoms. The infection of pathogen occurs through perhaps by adopting suitable management strategies. These diseases could be managed efficiently.